At Equilibar, we talk a lot about the precision of our back pressure regulators. Well, what does that really mean? Today we are going to demonstrate pressure stability through a 40,000 to 1 flow rate ratio. We will monitor the pressure on the inlet of our regulator with a set point of approximately 970 psi, starting at about 1 milliliter a minute of flow and increasing above 40 liters a minute. Here we have an Equilibar back pressure regulator with a PTFE diaphragm. We're going to provide the set point to this back pressure regulator through this standard nitrogen pressure regulator here. And we're applying about 960 psi to the set point pilot right now. We're going to bring in nitrogen gas on the inlet of the regulator through this micro needle valve. We're going to monitor the inlet controlled pressure, both with this pressure transmitter here, and then also with this differential pressure gauge. We're actually measuring the difference, the slight difference, between the pilot set point that we're providing and the controlled inlet. Right now, the inlet is about 4 psi higher than the set point. For the flow rate coming out of the regulator, we're going to first measure with a bubble meter to do the microflows in the range of 1 milliliter per minute. This is 1 milliliter. And then at higher flow rates, we're going to pass through four decades of Dwyer rotameters, all the way up to the largest being 50,000 cc's per minute, or 50 liters per minute. All right. So right now we have our flow rate starting at near zero. This is a bubble meter. There's 1 milliliter between these two orange hash lines. A milliliter and a cc are the same thing. So as you can see, we're right in the range of 1 cc per minute or 1 milliliter per minute flow. Right at the moment, our inlet is holding at about 969, 968, and we're about 7 psi overpressure, inlet being higher than the dome very slightly. And so what we're going to do is gradually increase the flow and keep note of the 968 and the 7 psi overpressure. So we're going to disconnect the bubble meter and switch over to our Dwyer rotameters. This is a full range of 50 cc's per minute. We're going to try to bring the microneedle valve up a little bit and control maybe in the range of 10 to 20 cc's per minute. It can be a little tricky to adjust these microneedle valves. There we go. So we're now dropping down into the range of about 20 cc's per minute, and we're still at 7 psi overpressure, and still at 969, about the same pressure that we had before. Now we're going to switch to the 500 cc per minute max rotameter, and I'm going to adjust the valve and bring the process flow up, the nitrogen flow, and let's try to go about 400 cc's per minute. And there we are, coming up around 400, and we're still at 7 psi overpressure, inlet being higher than the set point slightly, and we've picked up about a psi. We're at 970. Let's go again to 4,000 cc's per minute, or as it's listed, 4 liters per minute. Adjust the valve. We're coming up to about 4,000 cc's per minute, or 4 liters per minute, and we're still reading about 7 to 8 psi, maybe. And 971, so we've picked up another PSI, maybe a total of about 2, 2.5, 3. And now we're going to go to our highest rotameter scale, try to go to 40,000 cc's per minute, or 440 liters per minute. You can hear the gas coming out a little bit. And there we are at 40,000 cc's per minute, and we're about 8 to 9 PSI over pressure. And 973. So we've picked up a total of about, now it's coming at 972. So we picked up a total of 3 to 4 psi, but what we've demonstrated is a range of 40,000 to 1 flow rate range. We started at about 1 cc per minute here, and we gradually increased it to 40,000 cc's per minute, and we picked up well less than 0.5% of change in the inlet pressure. Contact our engineers today to see how Equilibar can address your challenging pressure control application.